When 3DS Max was first released, it had a revolutionary new feature called Auto Key Mode. Nowadays, this is something that we see in almost every 3D program, but 3DS Max pioneered the concept. And that is, in Auto Key Mode, whenever you change something, you automatically create keyframes for an animation. So let's test this out. I've got a camera here, and I want it to truck across the room. To make that happen, I'll enable Auto Key Mode down here in the lower right. The important thing to know about Auto Key is that when you create the very first keyframe on a particular transform or parameter, you need to be on some frame of the timeline other than the first frame. If you're parked on the first frame of your timeline, which is frame 0 by default, even if Auto Key is on, if you move something or change a parameter, you're not going to create a keyframe. You need to be on some other frame. So for example, I'll go down to the end of my timeline. And now, the very first time that I use Auto Key on this particular transform or parameter, it's going to create a keyframe at the beginning of the timeline and another keyframe at the current time. So let's make it happen. I'll select the Move tool, and in the top view, move the camera in the X axis, position it, release the mouse, and now I have two keyframes in the track bar or timeline, represented by these red boxes. There's one at frame 0 and one at frame 149. I'll disable Auto Key and then rewind and press play. And because I had Update in Active Viewport Only disabled, I'm able to see the camera move in all of the viewports. All right, so I'll press stop and rewind that. Just remember, the very first time you invoke Auto Key on a particular parameter or transform, you need to be at some location in the timeline other than the first frame. Because if you're on the first frame and in Auto Key and you have no keyframes yet, Auto Key will not create keyframes. Okay, so from then on, you can just park your time at wherever you want, like frame 70, for example. And if Auto Key is enabled, you'll create additional keyframes. I'll go to the top view and move the camera back in the Y axis. Release the mouse, and now I've got another keyframe there. I'll turn Auto Key back off again, rewind, and play back, and now I've got a bit of an arc through the room. All right, very cool. That's how Auto Key works. It's pretty simple. You just want to remember if Auto Key is on or off. You don't want to accidentally leave it on. That would be a problem, because then you might be working in some other aspect of your scene and creating keyframes when you didn't realize it. It's a classic rookie mistake. I've done it, everyone's done it. You accidentally leave Auto Key on and then go into some other part of the program, like the material editor, and all of a sudden you're animating colors and you didn't even realize you were doing that. Just remember, when you finish creating animation, always just reflexively turn Auto Key off.